Are you looking for an easier and faster way to schedule appointments? Well, let me show you how with Jotform Enterprise. Hey, Jotformers, welcome back. I'm Kimberly, and as you can see, I'm currently in my healthcare workspace. And like I mentioned, if you want to schedule appointments, you can absolutely do that with Jotform Enterprise. So for this example, I'm going to use our new patient enrollment and appointment form. So let's go ahead and edit our form. All right, let's go and take a quick scroll and look at this form. Of course, we have an appointment field. So under our basic elements, we have just the generic appointment field. We have our reason for visit and then a lot of other basic elements to collect their information. Now, one thing that we can do with this appointment field, if I choose the properties, we can sync our calendar with either Google Calendar, Outlook Calendar, or Calendly. So for this example, I'm gonna show you what it looks like with Google Calendar. And like I mentioned, this is a two-way sync. So this is gonna avoid double booking. And as soon as someone fills out this form, it's going to automatically update and make that time unavailable for future form fillers. So first, you're gonna want to choose your Google Calendar. I'm going to authenticate. If you have multiple calendars within your main calendar, you can absolutely change it right up here. We want it to create new events on our calendar, and we can even change the event title. So for this, I am going to delete this and I'm going to pull from our form fields. I want it to be their name, and then I'm going to do new appointment. Then we can also choose our attendees. I'm going to choose their email. For the event description, I'm going to put the reason for their visit, and we can also choose a telehealth option. We can choose something that is over the internet. So if you prefer something like Google Meet, or maybe it is going to be in person, you would put your office information here. So let's go ahead and choose to save. And there's a lot of different things that you can do within the settings of this as well. So we have the slot duration. So right now it's set at 60 minutes. If you want something specific, you can choose that custom time here. We also have intervals. So what does your work day look like? We can see we have weekdays. If we want to take off a specific day, if we want to add a new interval to just be Saturdays from 12 to 3, we can add in or take away depending on what is specific for you. We can also turn on the lunchtime. Right now it's from 12 to 2. I'm going to make that 12 to 1. Perfect. Next, if we jump over to our limits, we can choose to show only a certain amount of days. So maybe I only want to showcase 14, so 2 weeks worth of appointments. If we want to add in time off or vacation or holidays that we're not going to be open, we can add those in here. We can also choose a maximum appointment per day. So if we only want to take 4 new patients a day, we can do that. And then we also want a minimum scheduling notice. I definitely want a 24 to 48 hour minimum scheduling notice. Next, we can go over here to advanced and we can change our time zone. I'm gonna go ahead and put it in mine so that way I can see what that looks like with my calendar. We can even lock the time zone, but keep that in mind. They're only going to be able to see the appointments in your time zone. So just make sure that, especially if you're taking users from all across the country or other parts of the world, you leave this off so that way they can see it in their time zone. You can change the date format. We can even choose what day the week starts on. We can change the time format as well. All right, let's go ahead and give this a test. I'm gonna go ahead and preview my form. And I'm gonna jump over to my Google Calendar so we can see what this looks like. So I can see for the following week, we have something at 8 and at 10 on Monday. We can see lots of different things. So let's say we're gonna look at Monday specifically. So we have one at 8 and we have one at 10. Let's go ahead and we can see it right here. Of course, the day started at 9. But we can see that 10 o'clock is taken off for the 14th. If I jump ahead to the 15th, same thing. We can see on the 16th, we have 9, 11, and 2, right? 9, 11, and 2. So as soon as someone fills this out, let's go ahead and do a quick fill form and we'll choose 3 o'clock. Scroll down and I'll just leave this how it is. Let's go ahead and submit. Perfect. Now let's head back over to my calendar. And we see right down here, we have John Smith. It automatically populated. I didn't even have to refresh my calendar. All right, let's go ahead and head back. Now, one thing I want to showcase is our AI agents. I am going to head back over to our main Jotform button and I'm going to utilize Jasper. He is my healthcare AI agent. All right, we can easily book the appointment here. Or we could say we can test out that conditional logic. All right, let's go ahead. Let's do fill the form manually. Let's see what that is going to look like. It brought us to the form, exactly. So if we jump forward, we can see that those time slots are taken. Perfect. And it would be the same thing if we did the chat. If we asked to see that time, it would say, sorry, that time is unavailable. Let's choose a different time. And of course, something else that can happen once this form is filled out is it can absolutely trigger a workflow, or we can even utilize tables to send other forms as well. Now, one thing before I let you go is I definitely want to show you how to utilize this within our app format. So I'm going to go ahead and choose our types. I'm going to unselect all. I'm going to choose our apps. And we can see right here, we have our Healthcare Heroes patient portal. Let's go ahead and edit this. And this is where you can house all of your forms. So see our next video on how to build your own patient portal utilizing Jotform apps.